It's time for the Match Game. Hollywood Squares, Hour with Phyllis Diller. From Knott's Landing, Constance McCashin. From Magnum P.I., Roger E. Mosley. Charles Nelson Reilly. Fanny Flagg. And the stars of the Match Game, Hollywood Squares, are Gene Rayburn and John Bowman.
Thank you.
Here you are, bookended between two redheads.
Right. And I
couldn't, sandwich.
Couldn't be happier. All right, a little mustard and mayonnaise, some lettuce. Thank you. I'll do the whole show right here.
On your knees.
Yes. Yeah, I did.
Hi, Sailor.
The crowd is not the only one who's excited, are they?
Move right out to Hollywood Squares. Ooh,
well, I guess I'd better get out of here.
I'll help you up. Yeah,
thank you.
Promises.
I may never be the same. What are you off? No. Are you ready up there?
Ready. Yes.
You don't look ready to me.
Quiet.
Let's say hello to our two players over here, Angela Sweet and Sally Zimmerling. How are you? We're going to find out about both of them, beginning with Angela. Please tell us about yourself.
Okay. Well, by profession, I'm an interpreter for the hearing impaired. Oh my God, and for fun, I like to run and play volleyball and laugh with my pals.
Laughing is great, isn't it?
Yeah, it's
good.
Fabulous.
Keeps you healthy.
Sure.
Good for you, Angela. Now, Sally, you have friends here.
Thank you.
They're laughing already. She hasn't said anything yet. Wait till she says something. Amusing. Sally,
yes.
Zimmerlink.
Yes. I was born and raised in Cannonsburg and then Greensburg, Pennsylvania, and now living in San Diego. Married. I have a little boy who's 16 months old who's precious.
I bet he is. All right. Good luck to you, Sally. Now we're going to play the Match Game. We'll do three rounds. The winner will go on to challenge our returning champion on Hollywood Squares for a chance to win up to $30,000. Angela won the toss. We'll ask her to go first.
I'm going to go with A, please.
All right. You've got it. Og.
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 Og, the caveman, is speaking. This is what he said. He said, I just saw the world's silliest animal. It's a saber-toothed blank. Silly. In the slot, Roger.
I like that one.
You like it?
Let's dig it in.
Yep.
Okay.
Angela. Og, the caveman. You know him, don't you?
Mm-hmm.
Of the Paleolithic. He said, I just saw the world's silliest animal. It's a saber-toothed blank.
How about dinosaur? It was
would
same
that be
time
silly?
Period.
Oh, no.
Okay, it's round
something
one.
Something silly would be...
Cat.
Yeah, right. All right.
Yes.
What came to your mind, Roger?
Not a lot, but I just tried to imagine something that would look stupid with a big tooth. So I went small. I went for a saber-toothed mouse.
Well, that's good. Very good. Saber-toothed mouse. Yeah. You got the idea now, Angela, right?
Little late, but here we go.
Well, I thought it would be fun for a lamb, but I discarded
that. Would be
that.
Good.
Yeah, because they're so gentle and
yes.
sweet.
Oh, that's adorable.
A saber-toothed lamb. She put mouse. That seems to be the response.
Don't cry.
I said a saber-toothed little bunny.
A little bunny, it's good. Sweet.
Patty Duke just called for you, Charles.
Right. She's watching. She's taping everything you say. All right, John.
Oh, sweet Angela, I had so many of these in my tub when I used to live in New York. See, they're very, very ancient animals. Yes, saber-toothed cockroach, you see. They're very old creatures.
But the oldest creature I know of on this planet is, and I see them on my beach in Cape Cod all the time, is the horseshoe crab. The scientists say they have not changed in form or shape or anything for millions of years. Isn't that interesting?
It's not on this panel.
Neither have the Osmonds.
I thought it was the cockroach. The oldest.
Constance, are you with us?
I thought this would be funny, but nobody. Not right.
I think it's quite amusing.
Chicken.
Yes. Saber-tooth chicken.
Is it funny?
Yes, it's funny.
Tough crowd.
You don't know from funny, I'll tell you when to laugh.
Did you know that the roach is the oldest living thing on Earth? For sure.
The roach is?
The roach is. It's the oldest living thing. And do you know, I have this diet, longevity diet.
Yes.
You eat nothing but scattered crumbs while crawling along a counter. But, now what did you say? A saber-toothed dinosaur?
Dinosaur.
I thought she said dinosaur.
Dinosaur.
I wrote.
I like the idea, actually.
All right. Now, Sally, let's see what we have for you. Here it is. The scientist is speaking, Sally. And this scientist said, this telescope is terrific.
Oh, Lord!
Come back after your voice changes. It's terrific. Not only did I see... Not only did I see a flying saucer... But I could read the bumper sticker. It said, warning, I break for blank.
Do you mind starting off?
I like it.
Out loud, please.
This telescope is terrific.
The telescope. No, Phyllis, I just don't know whether he takes a shower with no clothes on. I mean, I don't know that much about Tom. He keep bothering me 50 times. Keep asking me this. Oh, excuse me.
Yeah. I met him recently.
Recently?
You know what he said to me? He says, hi, Gene, it's nice to meet you. We're talking about Tom Selleck. He said, you know, in the 70s, when you were doing the Match Game on that other network, I was a starving, out-of-work actor. I watched your show every day. Great show. That's what Tom said. Well, that, too, is interesting, I thought.
Funny guy.
Okay, Sally. Scientist said, this telescope is terrific. Not only did I see a flying saucer, but I could read the bumper sticker. It said, warning, I break for blank.
Naked ladies.
Naked ladies?
Oh, naked ladies. Ooh. Ooh.
I like your spirit, Sally.
You got it.
What a spunky answer.
Did she say naked ladies?
She said naked ladies.
I thought she said naked
Unlikely
ladies.
Unlikely that we're going to find any naked ladies here, but we must poll you anyway. Roger?
Not an answer anyway.
Saucer, break, coffee...
Aha! Break. Coffee break.
Coffee break saucer.
Oh, it's Roger, you're...
Saucer, coffee, break.
That's no better than naked ladies. Give it to
Don't me. Encourage that sort of thing. Phyllis?
Well, you said flying saucer, I break for cups.
Cups, yes. There's a little touch of humor. Cups, saucers, you get it? Oh, dear me, right. These headaches. Yes. Oh, there we go again. Real tears.
Patty, do you remember my last answer? I thought it was over, but I said little bunny, the sweet little bunny.
Yes, right, little bunny. That was your last answer. You break for?
I break for sweet little birdies.
Sweet little birdies who are flying around in a...
Dog, I'm funny!
Now, he's going to get violent, and he's going to walk right in that audience, and you're going to regret it if you agitate him anymore. All right, John, show and tell.
I said, I break for Ewoks. See, it's kind of...
All right.
Get half a rise.
Everybody's getting silly. Constance?
No, Ewoks are the George Lucas Star Wars.
Excuse me. Come on. Excuse me, John. I break for meteors.
Meteors! That's a good one. Miss Fanny?
I break for the Flying Nun.
Aha! So now you've had the round one question. You got those out of your system, right? All right. Round two coming out right after this.
Here we go with round two coming up. Sting. Let's see, the score's tied. She went first last time, so Sally, you're up this time.
Okay, A. I'll go for A, please.
You go for A. Mm-hmm. All right, you've got it. Old Man Periwinkle said...
I never should have gone out with Rhonda. After 20 minutes on her waterbed, I needed blank.
Chuck.
Eugene.
Here we go.
Eugene.
Old Man Periwinkle said, I never should have gone out with Rhonda. After 20 minutes on her waterbed, I needed blank.
A nap.
A nap? After 20 minutes on her waterbed, I needed a nap. All right. I think I understand. No. I understand your train of thought, but I don't know if that train of thought occurred over here. What do you say, Roger?
Those are really two attractive women. Over
they are indeed. There. Very attractive, yes.
Very attractive. However, in the match department, we're batting 1,002.
CPR, mouth to mouth. All right. Good. Hello, darling.
Hello, darling.
Love your outfit.
I had my cheetah bronzed.
You had your cheetah bronzed?
Yes. And this is something I love, mouth to mouth.
Yes, of course. All right.
It's cheetah. Get it?
I hope they're not looking for the shower curtain in the dressing room. The paramedics.
I needed the paramedics. All right. I guess there are a lot of good answers to this. What have you got?
It was a waterbed.
A waterbed.
After 20 minutes on the waterbed, he needed a lifeguard.
Oh. All right. I got a peek at Constance's answer, and hers is a very good one.
Excellent.
Ah, Gene, thank you. Dramamine?
Yeah.
That's good. That's the most.
The motion sickness medicine.
You think that's good?
Yeah, I didn't see yours.
Dramamine.
Very good. I guess that was about the best, wasn't it? Dramamine. Ready, Angela?
I'm ready. Come on.
All right. Nancy Reagan said...
Oh, Nancy.
Nancy Reagan is speaking. She said, Ronnie, dear, I know you want to appeal to the youth of the nation, but are you sure it's a good idea dressing up like blank?
I got a lock on this now. We got to match somebody up there.
That's
right. All right.
That's wrong. Ready, Fanny? Here we go, Angela. Right. Nancy Reagan said, Ronnie, dear, I know you want to appeal to the youth of the nation, but are you sure it's a good idea dressing up like blank?
Boy George.
Boy George. Boy George.
I'm sorry.
When I said earlier that was one of the two good ones, that was indeed one of the two good ones.
I know the kind of woman you are. Yeah, England, Boy George, yes.
Boy
yes,
George. All right. One for Angela. Phyllis?
I'm so sorry. A Boy Scout.
A Boy Scout. All right, that's Charles. Right.
You know, I wouldn't write an answer like that. First of all, I'm on a show with an MC that's wearing a corsage, and this guy over there is wearing an earring, and boy, rubs me the wrong way.
What'd you say?
Huh?
Come on. All right, Butch, what do you say?
Look out, your petals will fall. Michael Jackson!
All right. Michael Jackson and Boy George are the two good answers.
I wouldn't write an answer like that.
What'd you write?
Boy George.
All right, that's two for Angela. Constance.
I'm with Charles, Michael Jackson.
Yeah. Michael Jackson. Yeah. Fanny.
Boy George. Yeah.
Boy George. So there we are, round two, 3-0, Angela's favor. Round three, the final round, right after this for you. Third and final round coming up. Angela's head, you go first.
Well, there's two A's in Angela, so I'll go with A.
You want A?
Yes, I want logic.
A for Angela, she says. All right. Waldo is speaking. And Waldo said, It isn't easy being married to a motorcycle cop. On our wedding night, she gave me a ticket for blanking. See, Waldo's wife is a motorcycle cop. You understand that?
Now, which one is this one for?
This is for Angela.
This is for Angela. Okay, Angela, look, yeah. Look at me now. We gotta. Okay, we're hooked up here now.
All right, Phyllis.
Okay.
Shucks, I can't play.
Oh, I'm sure.
Oh, well, I know this is gonna be great.
Well, give it to Phyllis. Ready? Here we go. Waldo said, it isn't easy being married to a motorcycle cop. On our wedding night, she gave me a ticket for blanking.
Speeding?
Speeding is good. Speeding? What do you say?
Oh, I finally became a winner.
You are a winner. Speeding. Walker, Angela. Charles.
This answer's for David Trim and Ted Gonzalez. Two motorcycle cops. From Florida.
Bravo. She's up to five. Now we come to Constance.
Hello.
Speeding.
There it is. Now, Sally, you have one shot at it. The best you could do is tie, but you can do that by matching everybody. It's been done many times before, so listen carefully and give it your best shot. Rodney Dangerfield said,
okay.
I don't get no respect. Last night I came to bed, my wife said, not tonight, dear, you have blank. She is speaking to him. She said, not tonight, dear, you have.
She's asking me for his phone number now so she can call him and find out if he showers in the nude.
No, Phyllis, I can't do that. Okay.
Where is he? Is he in this hemisphere?
He's in Canada.
He's in Canada. Canada. What's he doing up there?
Oh.
She's...
What hotel?
Oh, I blew it now.
No telling. Here we go. Sally.
Yes.
Rodney Dangerfield said, I don't get no respect. Last night I came to bed, my wife said, not tonight, dear, you have blank.
Bad breath. That's all I can...
Bad breath?
Yeah.
All right. Have you ever said, not tonight, dear, I have a headache?
No.
You never said that? Oh, okay. Roger? You need everybody over here, Sally.
I wanted this nice young lady to... Well, at least you're an attractive woman, so you're always going to be a winner. But they always say, I have a headache. I feel with no respect. She'd tell him he had a headache.
Not tonight, dear. You have a headache. All right, what do the rest of you have? Headache, headache, headache. Everybody had it. Come on down, Angela. Yay! Right there.
Hi.
Sally, it was a pleasure to meet you.
Nice to meet you. Thank you.
And we're going to send some gifts to you from the match game. Sally Zimmerling. You ready?
I'm ready.
Good. Now we're going to switch over to the match game. Going to bring in the rest of the set, the stars. John and I will take place. A lot of excitement coming up. Don't go away. We'll be right back.
A member of our studio audience will receive Duquesne's Gas Grill in a colorful cabinet. American-made, featuring three burners, two for grilling, one for rotissing. And the steel cooking grid designed to hold heat more efficiently, furnished by Duquesne. And now, it's time for more of the match game. Hollywood Square. Our win from the Jeffersons, Roxy Roker. Leonard Fry. Barry Gordon. And taking over the star of the Hollywood Square, John Bauman.
Not tonight, dear. In about 2 minutes, and it's not a headache, it's Hollywood Square. See you then.
And now, John Bauman and the Hollywood Squares.
Welcome back, everybody, and here she is, Sweet Angela Sweet, who is an interpreter for the hearing impaired, and boy, you did a good job of interpreting the match game questions. 3 and 3, total 6 matches. You've done perfectly, and you're moving right on to Hollywood Squares. 3 brand new celebrities, they are Leonard Fry, Barry Gordon, and Roxy Roker. Leonard?
John.
Yesterday you treated us to a demonstration of your tap dancing...
The cards and letters have been falling in.
You were wonderful. Now, what is... Where did this tap dance...
It's just a gift. But the cards and letters have been so encouraging. I would like to reciprocate all over you by just a touch of my military tap.
Oh, please, please.
Hold the mic down.
Oh, yes, okay.
It's the military tap.
Wait, I'm too close now.
Wait, big finish now.
Leonard Fry! Thank you, Leonard. Angela, can you tap dance?
I can fake it.
Okay. Well, let's see if you can play Hollywood Squares. Here we go. And here's a lady who tap danced her way very neatly through yesterday's round of Match Game and Hollywood Squares. Her name is Tara Carpenter. Her total is $11,550. And that will buy the baby a lot of new pairs of tap shoes, won't it? But you don't have a baby.
I don't have a baby. I have a puppy.
And you're taking care of your niece, right?
Aren't you? Yeah, for the summer.
For the summer?
For the summer.
Oh, that's nice. What do you think your niece can do with $11,550?
Whatever I let her.
Well, it's good to have you back. You are not done yet. You're going to play Hollywood Squares at least one more time. If you get through today, you will have another shot at the big money. But Angela is here to stop you. We are going to play this game until you hear the time's up. Bell, whoever is ahead, goes on to play Supermatch. Can be worth up to $30,000, $100 for the first game, $25 for every square. Tara Carpenter, pick a star and let's go.
Gene.
Gene Rayburn.
Splendid.
The Washington Times is one of President Reagan's favorite newspapers. Who founded it? The Republican Party or the Reverend Sun Myung Moon?
It wasn't Mr. Moon, I'm sure of that. It's a conservative sheet, unlike the Washington Post, which has a liberal reputation. So I would say the Republican Party founded it.
Agree
or
disagree?
It's been around too long for Mr. Moon to have founded it.
Agree or disagree, Tara?
I'll have to agree.
No. Washington Times was founded by the Reverend Sun Myung Moon. No, you should have disagreed with Gene. Your opponent gets the first square. Angela, you're on the board with an O. Pick a star for another.
Phyllis Diller.
Phyllis Diller. You're having a romantic dinner at Burger King. Now, according to Julia Child, I love this question. What type of wine goes best with a Whopper? Is it a Zinfandel or a rosé?
A Whopper?
That's a hamburger, Phyllis.
No, it's what it says on my mother-in-law's doormat. Home of the Whopper. Listen, this is tough. Zinfandel or what?
Or a rosé. Julia Child recommends one of those with
You can't
the
get either at the place where you buy the Whopper. Okay, I'm going to say...
If
BYO.
Bring your
Zinfandel and what?
A rosé.
What color is Zinfandel?
A red.
Oh, then Zinfandel.
Angela, Phyllis says that Julia Child recommends a Zinfandel to go with your Whopper. Agree or disagree?
I'll disagree.
She recommends a Zinfandel to go with your Whopper. You should have agreed with Phyllis, and your opponent gets that square. So, perfect record so far. Two questions, two misses. Tara, try to break the string.
Fanny, please.
Oh. Fanny Flagg.
Yes.
You've got a cold.
Yes.
But you want to kiss your boyfriend goodnight.
Yes.
What should you do first to reduce the germs in your mouth?
Yes.
Take two aspirin?
Mm-hmm.
Or eat an onion?
This is Friday. I have to do well. I have pressure. Germs. Okay. You want to eat an onion?
She says, eat an onion before you kiss your boyfriend goodnight. That'll reduce the germs in your mouth. What do you say, Tara? Agree or disagree?
I disagree.
In order to reduce the germs in your mouth, you should eat an onion. You should have agreed with Fanny. The perfect string is intact, and your opponent gets that square as well. Eat an onion. It helps to sterilize your mouth. If I were the boyfriend, I would go right for the cold. Okay, we'll be back to complete a $100 game after this. Don't miss it.
Stay tuned for more of the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour. Now back to John Bauman and the Hollywood Squares.
Pick for the challenge of 25 for the champ. Angela, it's your move. Pick a star for an O.
Constance to win, please.
Constance would give you the game.
Oh, my Lord.
His real name is Leonard Sly. Is he singer Sly Stone or cowboy Roy Rogers?
Gosh. I think Roy Rogers is his real name. I think it's Leonard Sly.
You mean you think
I mean, I think it's...
Sly Stone.
That's what's said with such conviction. The other one.
Yeah. Leonard Sly is Sly Stone, right. She says. Agree or disagree for the game, Angela?
I'll agree.
Leonard Sly is the real name of Roy Rogers. You should have disagreed once again, you guys. All right, Tara, it is you have blocked there, and now it's your turn to try to break this losing streak. Pick a star.
Buried Wynn.
All right.
Okay.
The first right answer of the day would give you the game.
It would be nice.
Barry Gordon.
Yes.
You're a woman executive.
No, I'm not.
Oh. Well, next question. No. Pretend you're a woman executive.
All right.
In the middle of a heat wave.
Yes.
And the air conditioning is broken. According to Glamour magazine, is it okay to show up at work without your pantyhose? Or must you wear pantyhose no matter how hot you are?
Do you think I got as far as I did as a woman executive by having it easy? I mean, do you? No. I had to wear my pantyhose in all kinds of weather.
He says you must wear your pantyhose at all times, agree or disagree, Tara, for the game.
I agree.
You must wear your pantyhose. You did it. You're right to agree and just wear, and you win the first game. Barry's wearing his. All right, congratulations to you, Tara, but they're a bit premature because we have plenty of time. Take the X's and O's off of the board. We will move right on to the $200 game, which will start with Angela. Pick a star for an O.
Phyllis Diller.
Phyllis in the center square. Your pet earthworm feels dry and warm. Is he about to shed his skin, or is he dead?
He feels dry and warm. Mm-hmm. He's got a fever, obviously. Dry and warm, dry and warm. Is he dead?
I'm asking you.
I know. Shedding his skin or is he dead?
Right.
Boy, these are tough. My earthworm isn't dead yet. But I think he's dead.
She says if your earthworm feels dry and warm, he's dead. What do you say, Angela?
I agree.
He's dead. You're right to agree. You're alive. With an O. Tara, pick a star for an X.
Gene, please.
Gene Rayburn once again.
They're on a roll now, John.
They sure are. While visiting Russia, will leaving a tip in U.S. dollars guarantee you'll be treated well? Or is that against the law?
Well, I haven't been there, and I have no intention of going and enriching their coffers.
God bless you, Sam.
Thank you. That's the way it is. Here, here. I'm a
powerful
American.
Statement.
I'm staying in this country. Well, I don't know. Money is a universal language, and things are so tough over there, I would think that American dollars would be welcome. It may be against the law, but it would be welcome.
So you're saying that leaving a tip in U.S. dollars will guarantee you'll be treated well?
I would say so.
Agree or disagree, Tara?
I agree.
You agree. It is against the law to leave a tip in U.S. dollars. No, you should have disagreed with Gene, and your opponent gets that square. All right, that is a big break in the game for you, Angela Sweet. Ponder what you're going to do next, and we will be back to find out right after this. $75 for the champ, $100 for the challenger. A very, very close game. When we last left our heroes, there was a pivotal break for Angela. Can she take advantage? Pick a star.
Roxy to win.
This would give you the game and the lead.
What a responsibility.
Roxy Roker.
Yes.
You're trying to buy a tasty cucumber. According to the supermarket handbook, is bigger better Is smaller smarter? Or doesn't size count?
Does the size count? Oh, cucumbers, that's right, cucumbers. Let's see. Cucumbers. You know, to tell you the truth, let's see, we're growing some, we have a garden. And actually, sometimes when they're really too big, they're not really that great. Not the size. Size does not matter.
So size doesn't count. Agree or disagree, Angela, for the game?
I agree 100%.
When it comes to cucumbers, smaller is in fact smarter.
You're kidding. Disagree.
Yeah. Well, that was another possibility. Yeah. That was one of the three possibilities. You doped it out that bigger was not better, but in fact smaller is preferable. Your opponent gets that square, Angela, and blocks you.
Sorry.
Big break for you, Tara. Pick a star for another X.
Okay. Fanny, please.
Fanny Flag.
Oh, I'm ready.
On the average, who has a higher intelligence? Mm-hmm. Dogs or pigs?
Oh, I know.
You ask me this question? On the average? Yeah. Now, this is a trick question, isn't it? Well, you don't see pigs fetching a lot, do you? Okay, I'm going to say a pig.
She says pigs have higher intelligence. Agree or disagree, Tara?
I disagree.
On the average, pigs have higher intelligence. Pigs are very intelligent animals. You should have agreed with Fanny. Your opponent gets that square. Angela Sweet, now you got a mess of O's. Make your move.
Leonard to win.
All right.
You've read that book, Pigs Say the Darndest Thing.
This is our second chance at winning the $200 game. You've just jumped off the Empire State Building. Are you more likely to die during the fall or only after you hit the ground?
Oh, no. You die during the fall. By the 32nd floor, it's all over.
Agree or disagree, Angela, for the game, once again.
I agree.
You are more likely to die only after you hit the ground.
No.
You should have disagreed with Leonard, and your opponent gets that square and blocks you again. You die only after you hit the ground. Is that the good news or the bad news?
Come back,
Leonard!
Don't come to it.
You'll never tap dance again. Come back. Tara, you're still in it. Pick a star.
Okay, Barry to win, please.
Now, this could give you the game and increase your lead.
All right.
Barry Gordon, you sent President Reagan a letter containing your favorite jokes from Playboy. Will the jokes actually get read by somebody? Or will the letter be thrown out unread with the rest of the White House trash?
The fact of that is that as soon as they saw the content of the letter, well, they'd have to read it first, wouldn't they, to see the content of the letter?
Yeah.
Otherwise, they could be throwing out some great things.
It either gets read or thrown out unread.
I think everything gets read at the White House.
Okay. He says the jokes will actually get read by somebody. Agree or disagree, Tara, for the game?
I agree.
Those jokes will actually get read by somebody. Mm-hmm. You're right to agree, you get the square, and you win the game. Yeah, that makes sense. I think that's what James Watt does now, I believe. Tara, congratulations. You have increased your lead. There is, however, still time. Let's take advantage of it. Take the X's and O's off of the board. Start a $300 game. Angela, it's your move.
Let's go with Phyllis again.
Thank you, Leonard. You've always liked your ex-husband's parents better than you liked him. Mm. According to Ann Landers, now that you're getting married again, is it okay to invite your former in-laws to the wedding, or is that a bad idea?
Well, I know how I did it. It's okay to invite your former in-laws because you like them very much and they're friends. It's just that the husband was a louse.
Agree or disagree, Angela?
I agree.
Ann Landers says it's a bad idea. Things are turning sour for Miss Sweet. Your opponent gets that square. There's one X up there. Tara, pick a star for another.
Gene, please.
Gene Rayburn.
Yes.
How big is the average meteor? Is it the size of a 747 or the size of a grain of sand?
Well, there are many, you know, there are zillions of meteors in the sky, and I would say the average one is the size of a grain of sand.
Typical one. Okay.
Yeah.
He says, a typical meteor is the size of a grain of sand. What do you say, Tara?
I agree.
The typical meteor is the size of a grain of sand. You are right to agree. You get another square. Like meteors through the hourglass. Time passes, and it's passing quickly for you, Angela. Make your move.
Roxy to block.
All right, you missed this one. It's a humongous leap for Tara. Roxy, can you teach an elephant to stand on his head? Or would he get squished by his own weight?
Good question.
Oh, my. Let's see. An elephant to stand on his head. Their heads are so... I don't think... Let's see now. I've seen them at the circus. Let's see how they stand and balance and whatnot. They don't get on their own heads. He'll get...
Squished? Looks like a slow squish for Roxy's elephant. Is that what you're saying?
He can stand on his own head.
He can stand.
I'm going to say he can.
Okay. Change your mind. She says you can teach an elephant to stand on his head.
He's kind of delicate. They balance quite.
Agree or disagree for a very important block.
I agree.
You can teach an elephant to stand on his head. Right. Try it at home. You get the square, Angela, and you do block. But time is up. The bell has rung. She has done it second day in a row. Tara Carpenter is our champ. Congratulations. Good going. Good playing after a slow start. Once again, make your way over there. Join Gene. Get set for your shot for big money. Well, this is a case of ample opportunities. Ample opportunities, you know, to take the game or the block, and it just didn't work out for you, Angela Sweet. You still played very, very well, and you were nice and relaxed. Her total leaving here, $150 in our thanks for playing Match Game Hollywood Squares.
Thank you.
Good player. Gene, take it away.
Here we are. She's our champ, and she's going to have another go at the big dough. Let's see how she does in the super match right after these messages.
And now, here to play the super match is Gene Raver.
All right, we're ready. Thank you. You ready?
I'm ready.
All right. You did very well in this part of it yesterday. Let's see how you do today.
Okay.
We polled an audience not too long ago and said, write down your best answer to this. Cab blank. If you give us the answer they chose most frequently, we give you $1,000 for the second most popular, $500, and $250 for the third. And let's see what sort of suggestions you're going to get from the stars.
Fanny.
Okay, cab driver.
All right.
Cab driver. One.
John.
Oh, I like that one. So I'm going to say cab fare.
Mm-hmm. Cab fare.
And Phyllis.
Oh, yellow cab. Oh.
No.
It's cab yellow.
I can't do that?
Can't do that.
Oh.
It's cab blank. Maybe... Okay. Maybe something will come to you from out of the blue.
Yes, maybe someone will help me.
Calloway, yes. Have
you... Cab Calloway.
Cab Calloway, okay. So you have Cab Calloway, Cab Fare, and Cab Driver. Now you may choose one of those or think up one of your own.
Cab Driver.
Yes.
Cab Driver. I think you made the right decision.
Thank you.
Let's find out if it's up there. We'll begin down at the bottom and reveal the $250 response. Cab Fare. All right. One of them gave you that. The $500 response says, Cab Calloway. You got two out of three so far. Looks pretty good for cab driver. All right, slide it, Steve. Yay! You got it. All right, Tara.
You did it.
There's your $1,000. Now, once again, it's time for the head-to-head match with any star of your choosing. And after you've made your selection, we'll ask the star to reveal the number and multiply your $1,000 by whatever number is revealed.
Yes.
And there are four tens, four twenties, and 130 up there somewhere. Whom do you choose?
I'll pick John again.
John? All right, last time you picked him, he had a 10.
It'd be so exciting if I had it.
Well, nobody knows where it is. It's
no,
possible.
It's random, so.
Pure random. Here we go. $20,000 is what you are playing for.
Okay.
$20,000. All right. Good luck to you, Tara. Here it is, John. No help, please. Blank dot. D-O-T. Blank dot. John's ready. It's up to you to collect the $20,000 by matching him. What do you say to that? Blank
micro
dot.
Micro dot. I don't know. I can't think of anything.
You can't. You micro drew a blank dot. On this one. Well, that happens sometimes up here. You get up here, you're
micro
under pressure.
Micro dot isn't bad.
Well, no, there's one really terrific answer to this. I suspect John may have it. We'll find out right now. I don't think you're going to have micro dot, though. But
well, no, I actually got in the slot kind of fast because I wanted you to say the first thing that came to your mind. The first thing that came to my mind was polka dot.
Polka dot, yeah.
An excellent. I just didn't like.
You know, polka, it was kind of, that's really the best answer, but it was kind of hard to think of that, and I'm sorry you didn't.
I guess you
but
didn't get
but
so
you picked up another couple $1,000. You now have $13,050. Congratulations. We'll be back with her and the stars for a final word right after this. Yeah. Now we're going to find out which one of these celebrities had the one big number that's up their stars.
This is it.
The reveal. Ready, set,
go. Pull your tabs. It is Fanny.
Fanny had it.
You're close to picking Fanny, I know.
You almost did?
I almost did.
Well, that would have been $30,000 if you didn't win.
That's right. It would have been
so worse. Tara, you've got over $13,000. We congratulate you. I'm Gene Rayburn saying so long for the Match Game.
And John Bama saying so long for Hollywood Squares.
A member of our studio audience will receive Vitamix Stainless Steel, 3-Minute Bread Maker, and Home Yogurt Factory that juices without waste, cooks without burning, freezes instant ice cream, and offers 800 other recipes. This is Gene Woods speaking for the Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour. A Mark Goodson Television Production.